Hi, good morning.
So, do you start your day a little late every morning or do you start your day early?
So, I come around 11 o'clock to the office.
So, it's late?
It's late.
So, yes. You sleep late?
I sleep late.
What's happening at, so late in the night?
No, I have a small kid. She's 1 year old.
I get it.
So that she keeps me a little busy in the night.
So tell us, what is your favorite holiday destination?
Rome.
Okay. And how many times have you been there?
4 times.
Have you taken your 1 year old there yet already?
No, not yet. Not yet.
What's the one thing that you love to do in your free time?
I like to engage my kids, two beautiful daughters, Samiksha and Riddhima, and have fun.
What's the one word you use the most?
You know.
You know, the last book you read?
Pass.
Pass?
I don't read books. I just don't read books. I'm very bad at it.
What irritates you easily?
Punctuality.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, not a good day for us today. what is your thinking spot here?
My den.
Your den? Okay, and we're going to see your den in a little bit, right? Okay. What are the three words to describe yourself?
Ambitious, passionate, and strive for perfection.
Wouldn't you say a great father? Because you're sleeping at 1 a.m. every night taking care of the kids.
Absolutely, a dedicated father.
If you had a superpower, what would that be?
Maybe have 30 hours in a day.
Well, I think I know the answer to this, but I'm going to ask you anyway. Were you the kid who sat in the front row or the last row? I'm guessing last.
Absolutely the last.
Rajesh outside his work life?
Fun loving, great company.
If you weren't an architect, what would you be?
Probably a sportsman.
What is your favorite sport?
Tennis.
Oh, nice. If you could live anywhere else in the world, where would that be?
New York.
Wow. What's the one thing that people don't know about you?
I'm a good swimmer.
What advice would you give your 18-year-old self?
There's life beyond education.
Have you been scuba diving?
Yes.
Did you like it?
Oh, I love it.
Did you think it was overrated?
No, not really. I mean, as long as you love doing it, it's fine.
What kind of music do you listen to?
I'm a huge fan of rock music.
What's your favorite band?
Pink Floyd.
Nice. What's the kind of food you like?
I'm a foodie. I eat anything.
What's the one thing you can't leave home without?
Hugging my kids.
What's the one thing that's always there in your wallet?
I would say my mother's photo.
Did you have a mentor growing up?
Yes, many of them. But I would say the most important is my brother, Dr. Harish.
How would you describe the Taj Mahal as an architect?
Purity of love.
So, tell us a little bit about your office, because this seems like a really cool space. It looks like a house that you bought and you converted it.
Yeah, well, this is a 100-year-old building which was built in 1913, and when I moved in here in 2005, so we realized that the importance of the old architecture and the design was very much intact. So we didn't want to create anything new or break down anything. So we kept the same charm, the same materials which was used before, and then weaved the entire office around it.
It's really beautiful. The wooden flooring and all of that's new?
Thank you so much. Yeah, that's new. That's relatively new. Because we've been upgrading a little bit here and there to suit our needs. So yeah, but the essence of the place is still the same.
Why don't you teach me something? Could be anything.
What do you want to learn?
Well, I'm not a great swimmer, and I struggle with keeping my head outside the water.
Okay.
I can swim with my head underneath the water. But whenever I have to keep my head steady for a minute above the water, I'm struggling. So is there a tip?
Yeah, so the great tip I would like to give you in swimming is, like, when you enter the water, basically you need to take a deep breath and then put your head down into water, take 3-4 strides, and then come up again, take a whiff, and again go back inside for 3 more strides. That's the best thing you could do for swimming.
Yeah, that's cool. Okay, so that'll
give you a life.
Yeah, I know. So or what I normally do is I just flip over and I'm back. It just keeps me alive as well. So when did you start your architectural journey?
96.
Wow. And what was that journey like?
Beautiful. I mean, I couldn't complain.
Any budding architects that you admire?
Well, there's a lot of people in the market today. I like Humming Tree from Kerala.
Nice. What is the biggest attraction of being an architect?
I guess exposure.
And what is
due to traveling?
Exposure due to traveling?
Yes.
Okay. The biggest challenge of being an architect?
Satisfy the biggest needs of Vastu.
And would you say, you said, you know, exposure due to traveling is one of the biggest attractions. So which place would you say has been one of the most beautiful places that you visited due to architecture?
See, in terms of heritage, I would say Paris. But in terms of modernity, I would say New York.
Nice. What is your signature style?
I'm more a sustainable and a tropical design guy.
What's your goal?
Be remembered for good work.
What is the biggest achievement you've accomplished in your career, other than the 25 awards and the 2 international awards and the more that you're going to get?
Well, everything is close to my heart, but the most important one I would say is being nominated for the Aga Khan Award in 2010.
Okay. That's great. Biggest design mistakes according to you?
Oh, there are many of them. I can't list one for sure. I'm still learning.
What's a quick checklist to keep in mind while designing a house?
I would say context, then concept, of course respect for nature.
What about Vastu?
It is important, but at the same time, you know, you need to learn it to survive. So I think the basics are good enough. You can't do, you know, something called as 100% Vastu when you talk about design and architecture. So the basics are good enough.
Have you ever had a weird Vastu, you know, suggestion from a client, like keep my bathroom close to the dining room or something like that?
No, there's something more worse than that probably I would like to share. One client had come a couple of years back when he wanted his a small house, you know, in a 30-40 site to be designed with probably, if I remember, with 27 doors and 14 windows. So that was the calculation and it was like really weird.
Wow. I don't think that house had any walls.
No, they didn't need me, to be honest.
Okay. What is the material that you love working with?
Wood. As you can see, predominantly used in my office.
What is your architectural dream?
Be remembered, I mean, for good work.
What is an offbeat architectural marvel in the country according to you?
I would say the stepwells of Gujarat. It's an amazing design. It's amazing.
What's your take on the Make in India concept?
Positive.
What is your initiative towards being an eco-friendly architect?
A lot of respect for nature. So as much as possible, I include a lot of greenery in my designs.
What is your advice to clients?
I would say choose the architect well, because probably it's once in a lifetime you build a home.
What's the one thing that you would have done differently?
Nothing. Honestly, nothing.
Where is your working space here? Do you want to take us there?
Yes, absolutely. Please come along. And the thinking goes behind the designs.
What's the one question you wish you'd have asked you?
Who are my mentors in architecture, probably?
Who are your mentors in architecture?
I would say Jeffrey Bawa, any day, from Sri Lanka.
Can you tell us a bit more about him?
He's a wonderful architect, you know, because he's more into the tropical vernacular kind of style, which I follow deeply in my designs. And as a student, I was very, very keen to know his language. So that's how I tend to follow. And one interesting thing is both of us share the same date of birth. So that's nice.
When is that?
July 23rd.
Oh, nice. Okay. Anybody in our team from July? I don't think so.
No.
All right. So we're going to do what's your pick now.
Okay.
So quickly. Pottery or plants?
Plants.
Cement or resin?
Cement.
Designing a national heritage or building a city?
I would say heritage building.
Qutub Minar or Gol Gumbaz?
Both.
Recliners or bean bags?
Recliners.
Bar stools or ottomans?
Definitely bar stools.
Vertical gardens or terrace gardens?
Terrace gardens.
Friends at the beach or family trip in the mountains?
That's tricky, so I'll go with family with in the mountains.
Paris or Milan?
Paris, any day.
High budget client with a lot of interference or low budget client with zero interference?
Both. It's actually good. You tend to learn a lot with both.
So we're going to wrap up. Do you have any last words for your followers?
Have fun. Life is short. Be good. Do good.
And be on time.
And be on time.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.